Many devices today can determine their position and orientation using various sensors. It turns out that matrix multiplication is fundamental to the software controlling these devices. Let's do a quick refresher on the rules of matrix multiplication and then learn how to multiply matrices in MATLAB. First, we need to know if two matrices can be multiplied, and it depends on their dimensions. The number of columns of the left matrix have to equal the number of rows of the right matrix. The resulting matrix has the leftover dimensions, meaning the dimensions that weren't matched up for the multiplication. Now, let's look at how we carry out the multiplication itself. Each element of the first row of the left matrix is multiplied by the corresponding element of the first column of the right matrix. We then add the results together to get the element in the first row and first column of the final matrix. We repeat the process with the second row and first column to get the element that goes in the second row, first column of the final matrix. Can you see a pattern forming? We keep doing this multiply then add process for all rows of the left matrix and all columns of the right matrix. Now we can multiply matrices by hand, so let's do it in MATLAB. We use the asterisk or star operator for matrix multiplication. For example, if we have a matrix and a column vector, then their product can be computed using this command. Be sure to check that your arrays are the right sizes. If we try to multiply A and X in the opposite order, there's a dimension mismatch, and we get an error. Now that we know the rules, try it out on your own. For example, try multiplying X times Y. If the result surprises you, write down the dimensions of each vector like we did for our initial matrices.